And now, it's time to sit back and enjoy the Two True Freaks Internet Radio Broadcast.
Go, 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 Rangers, Turbo Rangers! Go, 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 Turbo Rangers, go!
Bouncing Blaster, Turbo Power!
Desert Thunder, Turbo Power!
Dawn Star, Turbo Power! Wind Chase, Turbo Power!
Red Lightning, Turbo Power!
Deep into the water! Inside the city is where you make a stand. On the planet Earth, out in outer space, you always cause trouble again in our face. You gotta move to, you gotta go to, you gotta hide cause the ranger gonna get you. You gotta run now, you gotta move now, you gotta jump cause the ranger gonna find you. Go, 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 Rangers, Turbo Rangers. Go, 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 Turbo Rangers, go.
Hello everybody and welcome to another episode of Ranger Chronicles. I am your host, Charlie Niemeyer, and today we're watching two more episodes of Power Rangers Turbo. And they are A Drive to Win and Cars Attacks. So without any further ado, let's jump into our first episode. I have the DVD queued up. Hopefully there will be a way to watch this online soon, after January 31st or after February 1st, depending on where you live. But if not, you know, the DVDs are the best way to watch. So we're going to do this here in 3, 2, 1, go! Sucker! Ladies and gentlemen, Carlos. So in addition to all the other stuff he's doing, he's also coaching a soccer team.
All right, now this time I want you to pass the ball to Barry. Let's just see what he can do.
Not a fan of the idea. Well, okay.
You're kidding, right? I mean, no offense, man, but tomorrow's a Stone Canyon game. Can't afford to blow it now. Look, just get the ball to me and I'll score every time. Listen, Carlos, you're a great soccer player and you're an important part of the team. But the key word here is team. I want to make sure that everyone gets a chance to play. But you want us to win.
I like that Adam's
winning's great.
Shirt, coaching shirt is green.
How about we try a little teamwork this time? Man, I can't believe this guy.
Oh, here they go. Yo, that's right. Hey, Ashley. Now I've heard. I've heard that Ashley was actually dating Adam at the time.
So let's keep it
That's kind of how she got on the show.
Okay? Gee, if I thought cheerleading was going to be this tough, I would have joined the army. Hit it! G-O, here they go! Go! That's right! You
got it! God, you kidding me?
Yes, 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 yes! Woohoo! This must be my lucky day!
Huh? What happened? Is that McMahon here with a giant check?
No, you pointy-headed
Wow. A pop culture reference.
That soccer game.
That dates this terribly.
I think I just found a new goal.
A Drive to Win is the 14th episode of Power Rangers Turbo. It first aired on May 19th, 1997, written by Jackie Marchand and directed by Larry Kent Lighten. Seriously?
What was that, man?
We still need to work on our offense, guys.
Pretty cool, huh, coach?
Carlos, that's not what I said to do.
Hey, we scored, right? Isn't that what you want us to do?
What happened to teamwork?
That was teamwork. I'm working to help the team win. Right?
Ouch.
Wow, this is some workout.
You guys catch on pretty quick.
That's because we have a coach. Hey, speaking of coaches, I wonder how Adam's doing with the soccer team.
Are they just throwing him on the floor? This is fun.
Tomorrow's a Stone Canyon game, you know?
Yeah, I would go, but I gotta go to...
Gotta go to the racetrack. We know. Come on.
Man, that elbow of his dented the pad.
Tomorrow's the big soccer game of the crosstown rivals. This is our big chance to get noticed.
But we can't play soccer, Bulky. I tried, but I kept tripping over my arms.
There's got to be some way for us to get people's attention at that game.
But Bulky, who else does anybody look at? Besides the players.
Skull, you're brilliant.
Cheerleaders.
Let's get out of here.
I bet you they're going to be cheerleaders.
You know, it's been kind of quiet around here. It's as if you know who has given up.
I find that hard to believe. It does seem like he's been leaving us alone lately.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's weird. It's like she's on vacation or something.
No. I got a bad feeling she's up to something big. Really big.
Well, right, you overgrown sardines.
I don't know, I kind of find it funny that they're throwing Tommy around.
And don't fail me this time!
Ah, she's got a plan. She's hatching right now. How do they tell the teams apart? No one seems to be wearing actual jerseys. Well, I guess a few of them are. Oh, so someone passed it to him. Oh. Good thing Adam's there.
Go, go. Everyone, clear the area. Get out of here.
I guess that's still practice. They don't have to be wearing uniforms. So the theory is that these two are being introduced here, and that they would eventually become Rangers, just not necessarily the way it worked out. See, initially, according to rumors, I can't substantiate any of these.
I think they're gone for now, but you two better go home just in case they come back.
But according to rumors,
you should rest up for the game tomorrow.
Yeah, I guess you're right.
Wait, why don't I?
JDF and Catherine wanted to leave. Were ready to leave the show, so they were going to do that in a nice, believable way, without it being suddenly like in season two.
I just got fished.
Yeah, we'll do. Never a dull moment around this place.
So, in order for their replacements, they were introducing these two to take over as new Rangers. Whether they would have been red and pink, I don't know.
You weren't so bad yourself.
You know, you didn't have to walk me home. I can't take care of myself, too.
I know. I just needed some excuse to talk to you.
Oh. I don't think the relationship continues once they become Rangers, though.
I don't get it. Why did Divatox go after strangers?
Yeah, I mean, we're the only ones that are a threat to her plans.
Look, I don't know what she's up to, but we better keep an eye out.
Maybe we should go to the soccer game tomorrow to make sure there's no more trouble.
You know what? I could just skip my practice heat tomorrow.
No, that's okay, man. We'll call you if we need you.
All right, thanks.
So my guess is that Adam would have moved up to red.
They work for scale.
And then Carlos would have been probably green. And then Ashley would have been pink, with Kat still staying, or not Kat, with Tanya still staying yellow and Justin staying blue. But then the new behind the scenes staff came in, and they decided to kind of change the whole thing. So then everyone left, except Justin.
Tomorrow we'll plant a detonator at the soccer game and... Sparky.
Again, this is all rumor. I don't know that any of that has been actually substantiated.
No, you'll mess it up. But you can go with Electrovolt.
That's a short monster.
Stone Canyon! We are number one!
a big day for Adam. I hope you know who doesn't ruin it.
Yeah, me too. Guess we'll just have to keep alert.
And I brought this just in case.
Good thinking, Justin.
Well, I definitely know Ashley isn't big on Carlos by the time we get to in space, but I don't think that she stuck around with him while they were in, when they became the Turbo Rangers either.
Perfect! Now all we need is for Carlos to do his stuff.
Why? Did you bet on Angel Grove again?
No, you knucklehead! The detonator is designed to activate when Angel Grove scores 4 goals.
But how do you know they'll score that many?
It's not connected to anything. How is it supposed to do that?
Carlos is such a hotshot, I have no doubts. And what he doesn't know is that every goal is a countdown to destruction. Now, get to the surface with Electrovolt and lure the Rangers away from the field.
The Rangers will get a charge out of this one! Come on, Bolt! Let's hit the airwaves!
Okay, wait a minute. The goal isn't connected to anything. The detonator isn't actually connected to anything. I don't think it's on Bluetooth. It's the 90s. Weird. Whoa, that's not Carlos. Oh, it's Stone Canyon also. Man, they score quick in this game. Soccer's never this quick. Okay, both of these goalies suck. Talk in the American footage, but he can only talk in the Sentai footage.
Look at him run.
For one, the mouth doesn't move, and second, it's the same voiceover guy.
Like Carlos is gonna do it for us.
Oh, this is so
nice
fun.
Wig on Ragog. Oh, dude.
Yeah, I knew that Carlos could do it. One more goal and kaboom.
Wonder if Adam would actually take Carlos out for that move.
Pretty cool, huh?
No, Carlos. I didn't think it was cool at all. I guess you don't know what teamwork is.
Okay. Or maybe Ashley will have something to do with it.
Come on, guys! Work up! Let's see some defense!
Hey, can you come for me?
Yeah, sure thing, yeah.
Come on, guys! Mark up! Let's see some defense!
That's exactly what...
What's going on?
Nice.
Elgar and one of Divatox's monsters is at the Angel Grove quarry. We gotta go.
Yeah, Tommy said he'll meet us there.
Man, Divatox has perfect timing as usual. Let's do it.
Shift into turbo!
Oh, also to kind of substantiate the theory is that you'll notice that Catherine has suddenly become second in command a little bit more this season. You know, kind of writing her up before she leaves. Although Kat and Tanya and Adam have been getting quite the good stuff too. Whoa, look at them run.
Alright, Elgar. Rangers!
What are you up to this time?
So good of you to join us. Electrovolt and I were just getting ready to go for a ride. Care to join us?
I'm sure you'll find the experience stimulating.
I doubt it.
That voice is familiar, but I can't place it.
Everybody get up. We're sitting ducks here.
Let's have a little fun!
Elgar's got a helmet on. Nice. That's called teamwork, folks. Hey, Blue Centurion.
Blue Centurion, wait. These guys are generating enough watts to fry all of our circuits.
Is that so?
I'm okay.
They were there the whole time, right?
We'll just see about that.
Is this footage from a different episode? Whoa, whoa.
You guys can't dance. Well, sorry guys, just got a little charged up. Let's ground these guys.
The only thing grounded will be you powerless Rangers.
I wonder if this is a combination of two episodes.
Break out when their opposite charges meet. That's your biggest problem. You underestimate the power of good.
Evil's more fun! When will I learn not to fight with soccer coaches?
Yeah, that's it. Okay, so now if either team scores, the bomb goes off. Man, good catch.
Put me down.
All right.
Way to go, Adam. I love this job. All right. No more Mr. Nice Guy.
Oh, now that's different. He didn't need the missiles.
About turning up the voltage, I'll bet you can power the sun for an entire year.
No matter how big you are, your brand of people will never win.
Oh, yeah.
Charge out of this.
Ooh. He's got some, you know, for a robot, he's... Yes. For a robot, he's got some, strong feelings here. Maybe we'll get a charge out of this. Basically, the rest of the Rangers are just pointless at this point. Wonder if they'll come in and help. Ooh, yeah, there they are.
Whoa, hold steady. We're gonna need teamwork to take this guy down. Let's do it. Turbo Megazord, spin out.
Synergizer blaster mode now.
Just know I'm gonna get blamed for this!
Since they didn't show the explosion, I'm wondering what happened there. Because they didn't actually show the explosion.
Hey, how's it going? The game's tied. We still need one more little win.
Hey, what's that noise? My turbo navigator!
Why didn't it go off earlier?
Cheering. I didn't even hear it.
Should have known.
Oh, okay, there you go.
It looks like the signal's coming from over there. Behind the scoreboard. It's in there. How are we gonna
How did they know?
I think I can reach it. Be careful, Justin.
Come on.
Send it to him, dude.
The key word here is team. Make sure that everyone gets a chance to play.
Barry, this one's yours.
Hurry, Justin.
And it's all because his girl said something. Whoa. Do something, dude. Although, take your time. He scored!
Yes! I can say that again.
That almost looks like a gold Midas thingy. I don't understand the... I would love to actually see the designs for these detonators. So I'm thinking, it looks like thought is being put into them, and then we don't get to see them. We are VR. Look at them.
This isn't working, Skull. They don't understand what we're saying.
We need the perfect cheer.
Wow, really?
Okay, that's enough. You're making me dizzy.
Man, how many pulp culture references can they put in here?
Thanks. I've got a great coach.
Carlos, hey, I saw what you did. That was pretty cool.
Hey, that's what teamwork's all about, right?
Right. Hey, so can you walk me home again? Just to be on the safe side.
I thought you could take care of yourself.
I can. I just needed some excuse to talk to you.
Are they gonna act cold in the thing now? Yep.
Pretty disgusting, huh?
I think I'm gonna lose my lunch. Elgar, this is all your fault.
Yeah, yeah, blame me. Blame the egghead.
But I'm not beaten yet. I will never let that millennium message come to pass.
Ooh, a reference. Nice. And more.
You're representing Angel Grove High. Remember? I'm sorry.
I'm not doing this. How many other guys do this? I can do this.
Listen, we're all tired. But remember, we're representing Angel Grove High out there. So let's keep it up until we get it right. Okay?
Oh, see? It's like a lesson. Because she did it until she got it right. Oh, I see. Okay, then. All right. That's it for that episode. We're going to take a quick break, and when we come back, we're going to watch our next episode, Cars Attacks. Be back in a bit.
Let's do it!
Keep the ride.
Fire the torpedoes.
Take a ride with Power Rangers Turbo Monday through Thursday after Ninja Turtles, only on Fox Kids.
And we're back, and as the menu changes to the next set of episodes, I realize this is our last episode before the season finale. Alright, Cars Attacks is our next episode, and we are going to get this started here in 3, 2, 1, go! Is that the belly girl from before? Since Kat's finding her, it's possible. Jeez.
Nice meeting you too.
Cars Attacks was the 15th episode of Power Rangers Turbo. It first aired on May 20th, 1997, written by Doug Sloan and directed by Judd Lynn. Jenny. I wonder if she's from the block.
I see you met Jenny.
Well, I wouldn't call it a meeting. Who is she?
My niece.
All right, so a different girl.
Problems with her and felt like she needed a firm hand for the summer. So she sent Jenny to stay with me until school starts.
Is she always this
friendly? Well, I haven't seen her since she was little. So I'm hoping that she just needs to adjust to living in a new place.
Yeah, I know what that's like. Oh, thanks. And good luck.
Thanks, Kat. Bye.
What's the towel for?
This is so scary. I hate auditions.
Kat, come on. These girls don't stand a chance. You've been rehearsing for months.
Yeah. Not to mention, you were in that one.
So have they.
You were in the what you call it? The Nutcracker.
Would mean to me getting into the Royal Academy?
Yeah, Kat, you've been talking about it nonstop.
Yeah, I guess I have been sort of into it.
No, she hasn't.
Everyone crazy.
Look, just forget about it. Just have a great audition, and all will be forgiven.
I wonder if this was originally going to be her reason for leaving.
Our final candidate for the afternoon is Miss Jenny Hunter.
Oh.
Here I am. Am I too late?
Not if you begin within the next 30 seconds, Miss Hunter.
That's her. That's Lieutenant Stone's niece.
I'm sorry. I'm new in Angel Grove. I got lost.
Miss Hunter, I've given you 30 seconds. You spent 10 of them talking. I suggest you don't waste any more time.
Right.
Dang, dude.
Did you know she was going to be here?
So, they think she's good, but everyone else thinks she's not very good?
You are right, she's amazing.
You're right about the attitude, too.
She didn't get her tape back.
The following dancers are asked to return at 5 o'clock for a final audition. Amy Kendall, Juliet Hughes, Ariana Landau, Catherine Hillard.
Oh!
And finally, Miss Jenny Hunter.
Why are they acting like that's weird? I thought she was pretty good. Oh my gosh. This is getting ridiculous.
There's nothing like a day at the ballet. Not! Quit fooling around! Porto!
Yes?
Get off your flabby keister! There's work to be done!
He's standing.
And I don't want a replay of last time.
Well, of course you don't.
Now, here's what I want you to do.
Okay, fork here. The 2, 3 plus 3 is
doing
six.
His taxes?
And, God, this is impossible. How did Ernie ever get these books to balance?
Oh! Hey, Skull, remember that account?
Hey, they're not playing. That's trick cards, nice.
Yeah, whatever. That's not the point. I just got an idea how we can prove who we really are and get turned back into ourselves again. Come on, we got work to do.
Okay.
What are they going to do? Balance the books somehow?
Closer now, Kat. Will you relax a little?
I hope so. It's just. This is where it gets really ugly, you know? The competition's just stuck.
And the Piranatrons attack. And Elgar. You know, I noticed something. His teeth are yellow in American footage, but they're pretty clean and white in the Japanese footage. What? Okay, wonder what he's gonna do in there. Oh, really? That tape recorder looks like one I had in, like, 1983.
remember to zero the counter, because when they start the music, the counter begins. And when it reaches 100, that detonator will go off.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I heard you the first time. Now get your bubble out of here. Now, let's see. First we pull the old switcheroony, and then gently reset.
It works not at all like that. There's usually like a button you gotta push, not just pound on the thing.
You are disturbing the peace. Shall we start again?
I wonder if Jenny's gonna be set up at all as like a red herring for Cat, being Cat's replacement, too. They're introducing all these somewhat younger teens, you notice?
I was trained at the Intergalactic Police Academy.
We owe you.
Just doing my duty.
Yeah, thank you.
You're welcome.
Hey, Lieutenant Stone. You okay, man?
You guys won't believe this. The money from the entire week's receipts, it's gone.
You mean someone stole it?
Idiot. Right under my nose, and I used to be a cop.
Well, maybe Emily put it in someplace safe or something.
No, she's...
Name check!
...visiting her grandmother. The only other person that knows where the keys are...
...are the monkeys. Oh. Jenny.
Jen, did you happen to, borrow some money from the safe?
What are you talking about?
Well, there's money missing, and
so
you're the only...
So you think I stole it?
You're the only one that knows where the keys are.
That's crazy. I didn't take any money. You know, you're just like my mom.
Well, that didn't go well. He also probably should have gone after it instead of just walking off. That was a terrible scene right there.
I made it to the final audition.
Excellent.
Cool.
Yeah, but, afterward, we did a little dancing with some piranatrons. Yeah, good thing the Blue Centurion showed up.
I wonder what Divatox wants with the ballet audition.
Look, I'll give you three guesses, and two of them don't count.
A detonator.
Exactly. Look, we better go and check it out.
Where's Justin?
He's at the power chain. Look, we better get the turbo navigators and check out this rehearsal.
You know, it's amazing how they have such a hard time, apparently, getting all the Rangers together in one scene.
Of course they're gonna look for the detonator. I mean, why wouldn't they? They wouldn't be.
Except for, you know, stunt guys.
Ruin all my plans.
What is that?
Elgar, are you expecting anyone?
Not me. What about you, Portal?
Oh, really?
How do you have someone ring the doorbell unannounced in a sub?
Who in the Seven Seas are you?
Allow me to introduce myself. Wolfgang Amadeus Griller, conductor, musician, and monster extraordinaire. No doubt you've heard of me.
Oh, yeah! Aren't you the one with the music video where the worms are crawling out of that guy's skull?
Hardly, my dear fellow. I've conducted symphonies all over the world. My
looks
music
like
can
a train.
Make virtually anything come to life. Perhaps you have a need for my services.
Yeah, whatever you say, Elvis. Can't you read the sign? No solicitors!
Wait!
That says no smoking,
did
by the way.
Did you say that your music can make anything come to life?
Precisely!
Here we go.
I may have a job for you after all.
Looks like he's got speakers in his chest, too. Weird.
Pew! There you are, Rangers!
Hey, Alpha.
I've got the
those railroad tracks are ladders, I wonder.
Ready?
Good.
Good timing. By the way, you can forget what I said about getting them all together. They're all sitting right here. Oh, that's cool.
Hey, that's no video. That's downtown Angel Grove.
Yes.
Oh, actually, that was Earth.
Symphony ever will soon fill the skies. A symphony of horsepower that will bring the Turbo Rangers to their knees.
He sure does talk a lot. He's by himself.
Spread your chaos everywhere.
From the readings I'm getting, Empty cars are coming to life all over town.
Looks like we just became Andrew Grove's Highway Patrol.
Yeah, it's time to pull this guy over.
Shift to the turbo!
Ah! Judd Lynn is running things, so we've reduced the amount of morph sequence. Nice. I thought I don't know if Power Rangers can catch a car. Never mind. At least not at this point. Oh, and is it almost time for Cat's rehearsal or audition thing?
I can't take that.
Don't worry, Adam. You won't have to. Turn around. Rev it up.
Yeah, now we've got him.
Curses, new instruments.
He just lets them. He just stands there and lets them take care of their weapons. That's nice.
Ready? Let's do it.
Good job, guys. Now let's finish them off.
My symphony is ruined.
Turn around, cannon mode. Brace yourself, everyone. We're fully charged. Prepare to fire.
You cannot destroy me.
Turn cannon, fire.
Well, you missed totally.
Maestro needs help.
Wait, the cars just faded away. They didn't go back to Earth.
Fire the torpedoes!
Where are the torpedoes?
We thought we'd get them all nice and shiny for you, boss.
Elgar.
Oh Lord. So I guess we're not gonna have a Zord fight. Or maybe we will, I don't know. Oh, we're getting close, folks.
There's a party going on around here.
Tommy, are you alright?
Drew's got reinforcements.
Glad you could make it, though I have things well in hand.
Hey, we heard your symphony flop.
Yeah, new tune, let's rock and roll.
Now what are you up to?
Whoa, that's cool. I gotta admit, that sound effect for hitting the Piranatrons and some of these monsters, it's kind of gross.
Now you meddlers will pay for destroying my symphonic masterpiece.
Loosen, Turan. Perfect timing, pal.
Playing loud music without a permit is a violation of code 41028.
I don't need no stinking permits.
And we don't like the way you conduct yourself.
This perpetrator is hostile. He must be forcibly restrained.
Wonder why it took Blue Centurion so long to arrive.
Conductor blaster mode.
Turbo auto blaster.
Wow, those blasts look puny.
Oh, not again! Demotox is gonna have my dome!
Wow, you can actually see the, torment in his face when he did that. That was cool.
Yes, our mission has been accomplished.
Well, until next time.
Wow, that was a Super Friends sound effect.
Let's go.
Right.
How does she know?
It's in here, guys. Oh, man. Search the room, quickly.
What?
Excuse me.
I beg your pardon.
It's gotta be here. Hey, it's this tape player. All right, I think it's about to blow. Get it out of here, fast.
Oh, they just said her name. They just said Kat's name. And everyone was there in the room.
That was too close for comfort, but we-
we did it.
Go get him, Dad.
Is everything okay?
I haven't the slightest idea. However, Miss Hillard, you are our last answer for the afternoon. Are you ready?
Well, just in time.
Ladies, you are both here because we feel you are the most promising of all the dancers that we have seen. Miss Hunter, you could become
a great
both
artist. Of them.
Thank you.
However, your attitude is completely unacceptable. It would appear you have no control over your emotions at all, and that makes you, in our opinion, untrainable at this point in time. I'm sorry. You're welcome to try out again next year. Now, Catherine.
I thought she was untrainable.
I'm pleased to tell you that you're invited to join us for the fall semester. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Wow, congratulations, Kat. Surprised she doesn't realize or nothing's being said about the fact that this would possibly mean she would have to leave the team.
Is this where we have our cozy heart-to-heart talk and hug and become best friends and everything's great? Look, Jenny, I didn't even know if I'd want to be your friend. You're mean, you're rude, and you alienate yourself from everybody.
Do you know what it's like to have your mother send you away because she doesn't want you? Or to have your uncle blame you for stealing? Or have the only thing you care about ruined right when you have a chance to get ahead?
Well, maybe not. But I know that you need all the friends you can get right now. Look, my advice to you is, don't blow it. My friends and I are going to be at the juice bar later. You're welcome to join us if you want.
Wow, it wasn't their normal sappy thing. Okay, that looks like fake ice cream.
Thank you.
That's incredible. You get to go to London and study now.
Yeah, I know. It is pretty amazing. But it's just one thing.
Kat, you can't give up this opportunity.
Well, you gave up singing to stay a ranger, Tanya.
That's different. I can go back to that anytime.
See? And then Jenny could come in and become the new Pink Ranger, and boom, 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 boom.
I can't believe you forgot to add in the inventory from last month. How many times do I have to tell you?
How can I add it in if I don't even know what it is? So it was you two all along? I guess I have an apology to make.
I'm surprised she's not getting mad at the monkeys, though.
I made a mistake. I'm sorry.
Forget about it. I'd probably blame me, too.
It won't happen again, I promise.
Oh, they're having a hug out, though. Okay. So all's well that ends pretty well, huh?
Ladies.
Oh, it must have been cold that day.
The most promising of all the dancers that we have seen.
What was that all about? You think she stole it?
I think so.
Yeah, totally.
It's just like chicken.
Rygar!
Hey! No! Elgar! I'm Elgar!
Funny. Alright. Well, that's going to do it for this episode. I want to thank you all for listening. I hope you all have a great week. Tune in next time when we watch Honey, I Shrunk the Rangers. So I will see you then, and take care of yourselves. Bye, everybody.
We are strong. We are tough. We're invincible. We are here. We are now. We're invincible. We are strong. We are tough. We're invincible. We are here.
Thank you you for listening to Ranger Chronicles. Feedback for the show can be sent to prchronicles@gmail.com, or feel free to leave a comment on the show's posting at powerrangerchronicles.com. Ranger Chronicles is now on Patreon. If you'd like to support the show, please visit patreon.com/rangerchronicles for more information. All images and music heard on the show are copyright the respective copyright holders and are used for entertainment purposes only. No infringement is intended. This show is dedicated to everyone, both in front of the camera and behind the scenes, who have worked to bring us Power Rangers since 1993. Ranger Chronicles is a proud member of the Two True Freaks Internet Radio Network. Please be sure to stop by twotruefreaks.com to check out more great shows. Thank you, and may the power protect you. And we won't see another day. You won't see